notes. The hair's getting grayer. The eyesight's getting worse. Got the granddad font size. Okay, how we doing? See if I can get this one in focus for a change. All right, I guess we're good. So this is it. This is the last day. The journey of the past 2 or 3 months of making this new album is finally coming to its climax in a few hours. I mean, hopefully you're watching this video as it's released and you've been a part of the journey along the way and you're experiencing it in real time. If this is happening in the future for you and the album's already out, then this is a little archival kind of behind the scenes of what happened last. But here we are. This is it. One more day to go. This video is going to break down what happened with the pre-sale, what happened with the concept of leaving traditional, what has become the new normal for releasing music behind and, you know, breaking away from Spotify and Apple Music and Bandcamp even, and trying to create a little more value in the art I'm creating, in the music I'm putting out. And in this case, I'm so excited for there to be a documentary film to accompany the album. And having had a film crew in the studio in Spain last month, this was really one of the kind of highlights of my career in terms of the way we did it. From top to bottom, every single element of the concept and the process and the people involved was exceptional. I really couldn't have asked for anything more from anyone involved. And we're going to get into all the details. By the end of the video, I'm going to give you all of the numbers, the actual numbers, the actual amount of money that people spent on the various options for the pre-sale. Not because I want to show off how it went. And I think you'll see it's not showing off at all, because spoiler alert, the pre-sale hasn't, as of the making of this video, covered the cost of making the album. But that is by no means a fail. As I hope you'll see by the end of the video, it's actually quite a big win when you compare it to past projects. And in case you haven't seen it, I did actually put out a detailed video going over numbers also about how much it cost to make this album and this documentary film. So if you haven't seen that, go in the top right. It's linked up here, worth checking out to give some context and some perspective about what this pre-sale success or failure, where we fit on that scale in today's video. That will really help the context of that. And what I'm going to give you today is break it down and tell you exactly what happened. So where to start? There were 5 tiers. There still are 5 tiers. If you're watching this before the album comes out, May 15th, 2022, I'm going to launch it at midnight. So there are still a few more hours if you want to be a part of the pre-sale. It's linked below in the description of the video. So there were 5 tiers to this pre-sale, kind of 5 different points of entry, depending on how much you were a fan of the music or how much you wanted to commit financially to it, and of course how much value you wanted out of your purchase. Tier 1, quite simple, priced at $20. It gave the buyer, the fan, the listener access to the music, of course, MP3 and FLAC format. There's a commemorative poster, something as of the making of this video we're in the process of making, because it's going to include everyone's name who was involved in the pre-sale up until today. So if you're watching this as it comes out, you can still be a part of this commemorative poster. Everyone, no matter what your level of pre-sale purchase is going to be included on that poster. We can't send out physical copies of the poster. Unfortunately, that's a logistical and a mailing nightmare. But what we're going to do is provide a really high quality PDF file for you to download and be able to print that wherever you are in the world for what I'm guessing is a very reasonable price. I know here in the US, you can have those kind of things done quite cheaply at a FedEx or a Staples, something like that. So that was adding a little bit of value right at the ground floor, right at the entry level in tier 1. And of course, if you've been following along, you'll know that I'm not releasing the album when it does come out as an entire 12-track record. I'm going to release it over 4 months, 4 3-song EPs over 4 months. I found and have found that in the past that a lot of people will get 2 or 3 songs into it and simply won't have time to listen to the rest of the record. And I really wanted this album to be heard. I want it to be heard as a unit, but I felt that releasing it in four separate chunks, four kind of digestible chunks of three songs, may give it a better chance of being heard in its entirety. So that will be happening from tonight onwards. We're going to release those in four parts over 4 months, where it will eventually become a complete album of 12 songs. Again, this is only available at my website. This won't be on Spotify. This won't be on Apple Music, at least not for a few years. I am going to use Spotify and Apple Music and those streaming services as a kind of archive once the album cycle has finished. But again, to give the music value and to make this project kind of not a financial disaster, and also allow it to be maybe even successful financially for me to be able to invest into future projects, that's why I'm keeping it off those streaming services. So, tier one, got you the music, got you the poster, and it got you access to the whole album right away. You don't have to wait the 4 months to listen to the entire thing. So really, all of these tiers of the pre-sale are geared towards, you know, real fans of the music who really actually are going to listen to the whole thing in one go. I have notes here because I can't retain all these numbers. So the first number, tier one, we sold 44 of those. That's 44, not 4,400, not 44,000, 44 at $20 each. By my calculations, that's $880. So we'll start the counter here. Tier one made us $880. Bear in mind, five tiers, we got four to go. Let's go to tier two. Tier two gave you all of that I've just mentioned for tier one, plus access to the documentary film. That's our big companion component of this entire project. I'm really, really excited about being able to release that, something of high quality, something that really showed the process of making the album. That was included in tier two. That was kind of the documentary film package, if you like. And that was priced at $35. So a bump up of $15. We sold 119 of those. And if my maths is correct, that came in at $4,165. We'll add that to the total right here. And just before we head to tier three, don't forget, the reason I'm telling you this is not only to be transparent, because I have nothing to hide and I really like that honest and kind of open communication with my audience. And perhaps you're one of these people who bought one of these pre-sale items and were curious about, you know, where you fit in that process, how that process worked. Aside from that, I really want to show you how it is possible to do this without GoFundMe, without Indiegogo, without Kickstarter, without throwing a percentage of what you're making through one of those crowdfunding services away. You know, and again, I can't reiterate this enough. This was not a crowdfunded project. It was a project I was always going to do, that the album was always going to be made regardless of how many pre-sales there were. So I said it on the previous videos, if there was one pre-sale or 1,000 pre-sales, I was always going to make the record. So none of this was dependent on hitting a financial goal through a Kickstarter, Indiegogo, or one of those kind of services. Really important for me to keep reiterating that and making sure you're aware that that's the foundation of the concept here, and that you can do this yourself. I am going to get to tier three in just a second, but just to point out one more small detail, I did this all on the website. When you click the link to yannickgwizdala.com below, this is all done through Squarespace, a simple digital product. It took maybe 15 minutes total to set up, and that was it. Really, almost zero expense. So the only real expense that comes out of all the money that comes in are the PayPal and Stripe fees, the finance, the processing fees for those payment providers. All right, let's get to tier three. Tier three was the full discography package. So that included the album, that included the movie, everything from tiers one and two, plus my entire discography, every album and single and live concert I put out as a band leader since I started with Mystery to Me in 2004. That entire history of my recorded catalog in both MP3, high quality MP3, and FLAC. So for those people who really kind of care about, as much as you can, of course, let's take that with a pinch of salt. For those people who really care about a high quality audio file and audio listening experience with a digital product, I'm putting that high quality thing in there as well. So that was tier three, and that came in at $60. That's almost double the price of tier two. And it was pretty successful, I got to say. We sold 93 of those, which came in at $5,580. We'll add that to the total right here. And just in case you haven't seen that video yet, or you haven't gone back to look at it, the cost of making this album, the cost was over $15,000. So I know you see the counter on the screen going up and thinking, whoa, that's a lot of money. Be well aware that the overall cost of making the album was around $15,000. I think at the end of the day, it's going to come in slightly above that. So just bear that in mind as I throw out what sound like initially some like, wow, some crazy numbers. But actually, when you put them into perspective, you can see what's happening here. So we go to tier four. Tier four, a little bit special. It's priced at $200. So of course it had to be a little bit special, had to add some more value to whoever was committing to purchasing that. And those were giving executive producer credit on the documentary film. So in the closing titles, all of those people that bought this tier four get a beautiful credit in the closing credits of the movie. There's also a meet and greet for the band, or with the band rather, band and crew. So my engineer and the guys in the band, we're going to do a live call. These people are all over the world, so that had to be a virtual thing. It couldn't be a physical in-person meet and greet. But we'll do an hour's meet and greet after the album comes out sometime in the next couple of weeks, after people have heard the music, they've seen the movie, and maybe they have questions about it, and they want to ask all of us, you know, what was our mindset? How did you do this? Some technical aspects, what pedals were you using? How was that piano set up? Like all of that kind of stuff. We're going to do an hour call with the few people who got those. As of the making of this video, we have sold four of those. I only made 10 available. That brought in, obviously, $800. We can add that to the counter on the screen. And as of the making of this video, that means there are six more of those left. If anyone's seeing this, wants to be involved, and that is something that is interesting to them, there are a few of those left as of the making of this video, until tonight, in fact. And tier five. Tier five was the big one. Tier five, I got the idea for from the NFT market. You can create a one of one piece that is yours. You have absolute ownership over that, and it can be identified on the blockchain. You don't need me to explain NFTs. The idea for tier five came from that because I wanted to make something completely unique. You may have seen bonus tracks on an album. You know, when I was growing up, I would see albums, you know, there would be 10 tracks, but then you'd get the Japanese release and there would be a bonus track or two on there, and it would be a 12-track album of an album you thought you knew from start to finish, and there were these other kind of special things floating around. So instead of having a bonus track on the album, I wanted to make unique one-of-one songs. I only made three of them available. We only sold one, but it was a big-ticket item. It came in at $750. It's no joke. It's a serious commitment, and we sold one of those, so that's another $750 we can add to the total for what this came in at. So as of the making of this video, you can see we are just shy of $12,000, which means we are well over $3,000 short of the total of what it cost to make this album. So I'm not here crying. I'm not here upset or thinking this is a failure at all. This was such a huge success despite, you know, falling short of the goal, because there really was no goal. That's the other thing that I want to link back to. This is not a crowdfunded thing. The expenses were not necessarily, you know, defined months ahead of time, because things change and there are variables and things take longer than you perhaps planned. So it's always a bit of a sliding scale. I knew I wasn't spending $50,000. I also knew it wasn't going to cost me as little as $4,000 or $5,000. So with experience, with so many albums, I kind of knew roughly where I was going to be, but it ended up coming out just above, yeah, somewhere between $15,000 and $16,000. And here we are at 12. Now you could look at that and think, wow, you really just didn't make it, man, and you're $3,000 in the hole, and oh man, that sucks. Well, if you go back and watch that video about me breaking down how much it cost to make this album, you'll also see that I said in my entire career, I've never broken even on a recording as a band leader. Not only that, but my entire discography last year in 2021 only made about $1,800 revenue total. And when you think about the fact that I've spent somewhere between $120,000 and $140,000 lifetime for 10, 11, 12 albums, whatever it has been now, not including this one, and not broken even on any of them, this starts to be way more of a success than I ever could have imagined, and definitely way more of a success than anything I've done before. And this is all before the album has actually come out. This is before the album has kind of gone on sale to the general public as a thing where there will be previews and there will be kind of clips here and there for people to make up their mind. Most of these pre-sales were made before a single note of music was even recorded, which is amazing to me. This just goes to show that I can trust my fans to have trust in me and they believe in what I'm going to do. They're invested. You, they, whoever's watching this is invested in what I'm doing enough to trust me to go and make music that they want to be on the journey with. If that alone is the success, just the fact that people were interested, regardless of the dollar amount that came in, that alone is a massive success. And I want to share a few quick things with you about the album and kind of what went on in the studio. I want to highlight the fact that I wasn't going into the studio to make this kind of album or this kind of album or this kind. It wasn't a jazz album. It wasn't a groove album. It wasn't an ambient album. It wasn't a purely melodic album. It ended up being exactly what I wanted it to be, which was an honest representation of what was happening musically at the moment that we were recording. And I did compose some music for the session, and there are some melodic moments on the album for sure. And there are also very cinematic sounding ambient soundscapes on the album as well, which were completely improvised in the moment. And you get to hear our collective rhythmic influences and upbringing and backgrounds as an improvising ensemble in some pretty kind of punchy and hard-hitting, sometimes like super out there, and also sometimes just super in the pocket and happy to sit in one place. But most importantly, what I think we were able to accomplish as an ensemble and with Juan Pablo at the controls, making it sound the way it sounds, we were able to achieve complete honesty and fearlessness. We created an environment without restriction. I think that's probably the best way to put it. And the movie explains so much more. It's a feature-length documentary. It's almost 50 minutes long. It features some of the music that didn't make it on the album. I guess this is my shameless plug for the movie now, because that will be available through Vimeo. That will be available for sale after the pre-sale ends and the album is actually kind of out there and on sale to people. The movie will be available to view through Vimeo. And we really got to the heart of where we all come from as musicians, and kind of guided by Juan Pablo and assisted in making that environment like the kind of safest space possible to improvise and to feel like no restrictions whatsoever. I think that was probably the highest level musically that I've ever been able to operate at. It was the most free. It was the most honest. And I think it was probably the most satisfying studio experience I might ever have had in my life. So it's been a big few months for me. We went into the studio with this really kind of specific intent, even though the music wasn't totally specific. We had this intent to be honest. And I think we achieved that. And it's kind of only the beginning. Now comes the touring, now comes future projects. Now we have this nucleus, this kind of starting point and this core to build some really amazing things from. So I hope you dig the music. I hope you dig the explanation of how the pre-sale worked. Like I said, if you're watching this right when the video is coming out, you can still pre-order the album. Of course, it helps this number go up. It helps the project. It helps me invest in not only this project, but future projects as well. And I hope the entire concept and the story and the music and the movie helps you make better informed decisions about your own music. If you're thinking about being an artist, if you're thinking about making a recording, if you're trying to come up with, you know, how the hell do I make this work? Here's the thing. All you need is the will to make it happen. All the technical information is out there. It's not that complicated. Pretty much anyone with an internet connection and a laptop can make it happen. You just need the willpower, the honesty, and and the hard work ethic, and you can pretty much make anything happen that you want. So that's it. That's enough from me. Pre-order still open for a few hours. If it's way past May 15th, 2022, consider going over to the website anyway, janekgwizdala.com. There are some audio previews there. There's a trailer for the movie. It's all out there. I'll see you on the road. That's the next milestone for us, taking some tour dates in Europe around August now, 2022 and beyond. Love you guys. Thank you so much for sticking around this long in the video. See you on the next one.